board you are seeing. All of you, good morning, my dear students. Today's topic is electrophilic substitution reactions in ethers. All of you know, whenever an aromatic group is there, benzene ring, aromatic group is there, benzene ring containing compounds generally undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions very fastly. That was already explained in the previous classes also. So here I am going to consider an ether. Which type of ether? Alkyl aryl ether is considered. Alkyl aryl ethers, how they are represented? Alkyl group is represented as R single bond. Ether group is single bond or single bond. Aryl group is AR. So R stands for alkyl group, AR stands for aryl group. This is an example of mixed ether. Alkyl aryl ethers are the examples of mixed ethers. So instead of R, I am taking the CH3 methyl. Next, single bond was single bond, this is the ether group, and instead of AR aryl group, I am taking C6H5. C6H5 single bond is called as phenyl, right? So CH3 single bond, O single bond, CH3 is represented as C6H5 single bond, means benzene ring with single bond. Next one is single bond O single bond. This is a single bond O single bond. Next one is CH3. So this formula can be represented as like this one. Benzene ring, single bond O, single bond CH3. This compound is called as anisole. Very, very important compound, anisole. What is the formula of anisole? C6H5 single bond O single bond CH3. This is the anisole, and ether group is always acting as a substitute. So CH3O is acting as a substitute. Methyl plus oxy, methoxy is the substitute that is present on the benzene ring. So this compound's IUPAC name is methoxy benzene, and the common name of this compound is anisole. Nowadays, even though anisole is a common name, still it is accepted as IUPAC name. So today we are going to discuss about electrophilic substitution reactions of anisole. And one more example for alkyl aryl ether is, instead of R alkyl group, I am going to consider ethyl, C2H5 ethyl. Now the compound is C6H5 single bond O single bond C2H5. This is the representation of the compound. And C2H5 single bond O, this group is acting as the substitute. Ethyl plus oxy, called as ethoxy, present on the benzene ring. Hence the IUPAC name of the compound is ethoxy benzene. The formula is written as C6H5 single bond O single bond C2H5. So these two are the simple examples for alkyl aryl ethers. Now I am going to consider anisole, the example for alkyl aryl ether. IUPAC name of anisole is methoxy benzene. Already I said that whenever the aryl group is present, such compounds readily undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions. And one more thing you have to observe, in the anisole, which group is present means CH3 single bond O single bond group is present. In the anisole, CH3 single bond O single bond group is present, whether it is an example of electron donating group or it is an example of electron withdrawing group. EDG means electron donating group, EWDG means electron withdrawing group. Yes, text me whether this group CH3 single bond was CH3 single bond was single bond, whether this group is electron donating or electron withdrawing. Text me your answer, whether it is an example of electron donating or electron withdrawing. Single bond O, single bond CH3 group, whether it is an example of electron donating group or electron withdrawing group. Waiting for your response. Methoxy group, methyl plus oxy, methoxy group, whether it is an example of electron donating group or electron withdrawing group. Mahesh Babu, you, electron donating group. Remaining persons can text the same, because already voice is reached to you. So simply you can text. Anyhow, so in the anisole, CH3O group is acting as electron donating group. Already you know that whenever the electron donating group is present, when the electron donating group is present on the benzene ring, electrophilic substitution reactions will take place in the benzene ring. Once again, when the electron donating group is present on the benzene ring, electrophilic substitution reactions will take place in the benzene ring at ortho position and at para position. And ortho products are, the ortho products formed are minor products, whereas para products formed are going to be the major products. So regarding this one, we are going to discuss three reactions. First, we are going to discuss the reaction. The reaction first one is, on the screen you can see now. On the screen you can see the first reaction, halogenation. Halogenation of anisole. Once, read on the screen. Read the content on the screen. Halogenation of anisole. The first reaction. Halogenation. Reaction with halogens is called as halogenation. Halogenation of anisole. Halogenation of anisole. Halogenation is going to be carried in presence of ethanoic acid. The halogenation is carried in presence of ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is nothing but acetic acid. The formula of acetic acid is CH3COOH. Already I said that during the halogenation in the laboratory, generally we carry chlorination or bromination. All of you know the reactivity of halogens. Among the halogens, which are more reactive? Halogens are represented as X2. X2, that is F2, Cl2, Br2, and I2. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Tell me, which one is more reactive? Which one is more reactive? Sushma. Sushma is saying iodine is more reactive. Gayatri is saying iodine is more reactive. Remaining persons should respond. Chirant, tell me among the halogens, which one is more reactive? Among the F2, Cl2, Br2 and I2, which one is more reactive? Yes, correct answer, Chirant. F2 is more reactive. Just a minute. So F2 is written as fluorine single bond fluorine. Cl2 is written as chlorine single bond chlorine. Br2 is written as bromine single bond bromine. I2 is written as iodine single bond iodine. All these belongs to 7th A group elements. 7th A group elements. 7th A group elements are electronegative in nature. Highly electronegative in nature. In the first PLC you studied in the periodic table, 7th A group elements are highly electronegative in nature. Whereas if you come to the 1st A group elements, alkali metals. 1st A group elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. In the first year group elements, are going to contain electropositivity. Electropositivity means tendency to lose the electrons. Electronegativity means tendency to gain the electrons. Once again, electronegativity means tendency to gain the electrons. Electropositivity means tendency to lose the electrons. Yes, all of you know, in a group from top to bottom, atomic size increases. Once again, In a group from top to bottom, atomic size increases. From lithium to cesium, as the atomic size increases, tendency to lose the electrons increases. Once again, my statement. In a group from top to bottom, as the atomic sizes increases, tendency to lose the electrons increases. So among the lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium, which is ready to lose the electron? cesium is loses the electron readily. So which is more reactive? In the first year group elements, cesium is more reactive. That means in the first year group elements, down the group, in the first year group elements, down the group, reactivity. In the first year group elements, down the group, reactivity increases. So which one is more reactive means? Cesium is more reactive. Whereas coming to the seventh year group elements, here you are seeing the seventh year group elements, fluorine F2, chlorine Cl2, bromine Br2, iodine I2. And the seventh year group elements are electronegative in nature. Electronegativity means tendency to gain the electrons. Among the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, which is ready to gain the electron? Among the F2, Cl2, Br2, I2, which is ready to gain the electron? Highly electronegative elements are ready to gain the electron. Once again, highly electronegative elements are ready to gain the electron. Fluorine is highly electronegative. It is ready to gain the electron. So which one is more reactive? Which one is more reactive? F2 is more reactive. So in the seventh year group elements, topmost element is more reactive. In the seventh year group elements, topmost element is more reactive. Whereas in the first year group elements, bottommost element is the more reactive. Because the first year group elements are electropositive in nature, seventh year group elements are electronegative in nature. So in the first POC, you studied already about this one, as well as in the second POC, P block elements, 17th group elements also you studied about this one. So now we can say that among the halogens, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, which one is more reactive? Which one is more reactive means fluorine, F2 is more reactive. Now coming to the concept, halogenation of anisole. In the halogenation, fluorine is highly reactive. Highly reactive means in the laboratories, explosion will take place. That's why we are not going to carry the fluorination in the laboratory. Iodine is very, very less reactive. Very, very less reactive. So in the laboratories, we are not going to carry the iodination. So in the laboratories, what we are going to carry? Halogenation means either it is the chlorination reaction or it is the bromination reaction. So I'm going to consider either chlorination or bromination of anisole. Chlorination or bromination of anisole. Either it is the chlorination or it is the bromination of anisole, that is the halogenation of anisole. Yes, on the screen once again. On the screen once again, you can see the reaction. Halogenation of anisole. Yes, anisole formula. Anisole is represented as C6H5, single bond O, single bond CH3. This is anisole. C6H5, single bond O, single bond CH3 is anisole. When anisole is undergoing bromination, reaction with bromine in presence of ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is nothing but acetic acid. The formula of ethanoic acid or acetic acid is CH3COOH. Yes, already I said that halogenation reactions are the examples of electrophilic substitution reactions. Electrophilic substitution reactions will take place at ortho position as well as at para position. So ortho position is going to be substituted. The ortho position is going to be substituted with halogen. This is the ortho position. Ortho position is going to be substituted with halogen. This is the para position. Para position is going to be substituted with the halogen. Then we can write the product. First, I am taking the anisole. No change in the anisole. There is no change in the anisole. Now the ortho position is going to be substituted with electrophile. What is the electrophile substituted here? The electrophile substituted is Br plus, but not Br minus. Br minus means, minus ions means nucleophiles. Plus ions are the electrophiles. So during the halogenation reaction, what is going to be substituted? During the halogenation reactions, what is going to be substituted? X plus ions are going to be substituted. X plus ions are called as halonium ions. The X plus ions are called as halonium ions. Here, Br plus ion is going to be substituted. Br plus ion is going to be substituted. Br plus ion is called as Br plus ion is called as bromonium ion. Br plus ion is called as bromonium ion. This Br plus ion in this reaction is acting as electrophile. So for the CET and NEET, you have to remember this one. So during the halogenation, what is going to be the electrophile? X plus ions are going to be the electrophiles. That means halogen ions are going to be the electrophiles, and that electrophiles are going to be substituted. The electrophiles are going to be substituted at ortho position as well as at para position. Now, clearly, I am going to write the reaction. Halogenation of anisole. Here I am saying about bromination of anisole. The bromination of anisole is an example of electrophilic substitution reaction, and the simple reaction is
C6H5 single bond was single bond CH3
methoxy benzene. Simply it is called as anisole reacting with bromine in presence of ethanoic acid. Text me whether the class is understanding or not. Please text me. So first of all, I am taking the same anisole without any change. The reactant is taken as it is. No change in anisole, but ortho position is going to be substituted with Br plus. So this is the ortho bromo anisole, and simultaneously one more product is going to be formed. That product is, again we are taking the anisole as it is, no change in the reactant. First anisole is taken. Now the para position is substituted with bromine. The compound is called as para bromo. P hyphen means para bromo anisole is going to be the major product. Ortho bromo anisole is going to be the minor product. Nearly 90% of para-bromo anisole is going to be formed in this reaction, and at nearly 10% of ortho-bromo anisole is going to be formed. So this is all about halogenation of anisole in the presence of ethanoic acid. The ethanoic acid, the formula is written as CH3COOH. So this is about halogenation. Next, coming to the second electrophilic substitution reaction. Yes, in the first PSC also you studied this reaction. Friedel-Crafts reaction. My dear students, please text me whether the screen is shared to you or not. Whether the file is open to you or not, text me. Whether the screen sharing is coming to you. Okay, fine, thank you. So in the last POC, first POC, you studied the second reaction, that is the Friedel-Crafts reaction. Friedel-Crafts reactions, very, very important one, you have to remember. The Friedel-Crafts reactions are also the examples of electrophilic substitution reactions. So the second reaction here is Friedel-Crafts reaction. Friedel, scientist names. Friedel and Croft. These two are the scientist names. Friedel-Crafts reaction. In the Friedel-Crafts reaction, you studied about alkylation and acylation. Alkylation reactions. To carry the alkylation reactions, we are going to take a mixture of anhydrous AlCl3. And CH3Cl. Here the alkyl group is there. What is the alkyl group present here? Methyl group is the alkyl group. Here the methyl group is the alkyl group. And anhydrous aluminium chloride. This is going to act as Lewis acid. The anhydrous aluminium chloride is acting as Lewis acid. It acts as a catalyst. So once again, you have to remember what is the combination of alkylation. To carry the alkylation reaction, you have to take a mixture of anhydrous aluminium chloride with alkyl halides. CH3Cl is nothing but alkyl halide. And the second reaction, to carry the acylation reaction, we have to take acyl chloride.
What is acyl? R single bond, C double bond, O single bond. On the screen, I'm going to write. On the board, I'm going to write. What is acyl group? Acyl group means R single bond, C double bond, O single bond group is called as acyl group. So first, we are going to study Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Yes, all of you know about this one. Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Already you know this one. That's why I'm going a little bit faster. Alkylation reactions of anisole. Alkylation reactions of anisole. First, I am taking the anisole. This is anisole. And reacted with alkyl halide. Alkyl group. CH3 is the alkyl group. Halide. I am taking the chlorine. CH3Cl. Methyl chloride. This is an example of alkyl halide. So instead of writing CH3Cl, simply I can write RX. R stands for alkyl group, X stands for halide. And this reaction is carried in the presence of anhydrous Lewis acid. Anhydrous Lewis acid. Here AlCl3 is taken as Lewis acid. This is acting as a catalyst. And the electrophile is going to be substituted. What is the electrophile going to be substituted? CH3 plus of methyl chloride. CH3 plus of methyl chloride is acting as electrophile. CH3 plus, that is a methyl carbocation. Methyl carbocation is acting as electrophile. That is going to be substituted at ortho position and para position in the anisole. This is the anisole. And this one is the ortho position. This one is the para position. So first of all, we are taking the same reactant, anisole, as it is. The reactant is taken as it is. Now the ortho position is substituted with alkyl group. Here the alkyl group taken is methyl group. Plus another product. Another product. Again, anisole is taken as it is. This is anisole. Anisole is taken as it is. Now the para position. This is the para position. Para position substituted with CH3. Yes. Now the question will arise. What should be the names of the compounds? What should be the names of the compounds? The names of the compounds are, to name the IUPAC name, always we know that ether group is not having suffix. Once again, if we see the table, IUPAC table, ether group is not having suffix. Ether group is having only prefix. Prefix means ether groups always act as substitute. So ether group is acting as substitute means this group is acting as a substitute. What is the substitute? Methyl plus oxy, methoxy. So this carbon is taken as first carbon. This carbon is taken as second carbon. Here, this carbon is taken as first carbon and this carbon is taken as fourth carbon. Now the substitute is second carbon having substitute, methyl plus oxy. Methyl plus oxy, methoxy. Benzene ring with CH3. Benzene ring with CH3 is called as benzene ring with CH3 is called as toluene. Toluene. So the compound named as 2-methoxytoluene. It is an example of ortho product. 2-methoxytoluene is an example of ortho product. Whereas the second product is. What is the second product? What is the second product? Wait a minute. Yes. What is the second product? The second product is fourth carbon having methoxy group. Fourth carbon having methoxy group, 4-methoxy benzene. So this is about alkylation of anisole, right? Similarly, now we are going to carry acylation of anisole. Similarly, we are going to carry the acylation of anisole. Acylation or acetylation. Acylation or acetylation. Acetylation or acylation. To carry the acetylation, we have to take acyl group. What is acyl group? R single bond, C double bond, O single bond. Once again, R single bond, C double bond, O single bond is called as acyl group. If R is replaced with CH3, if the R is replaced with CH3, that is called as acetyl. CH3 single bond, C double bond, O single bond. This group is called as acetyl group. Now the chloride, acetyl chloride. Now here the electrophile is. What is the electrophile here? CH3 single bond, C double bond O plus. Because from this acetyl chloride, if we remove the Cl minus, we will get CH3 single bond, C double bond O plus. This is the acetyl group with positive charge. It is acting as electrophile. So in the acetylation reaction, what is the electrophile? This is about CH3 bit. So the acetylation, the electrophile is CH3 single bond, C double bond O plus is the electrophile during the acetylation reaction. And the acetylation is going to take place at ortho position and para position. So first I'm taking the anisole as it is. Ortho position is substituted. This is the ortho position substituted with C double bond O single bond CH3. C double bond O single bond CH3. Plus next another product. What will be the another product? The another product is para product. So first of all, I'm taking the anisole as it is. This is anisole as it is. Now the para position. Para position is substituted with C double bond O, single bond CH3. Yes, once again, this is the ether group. This is the ketone. Ketone is acting as a functional group. This is a ketone, functional group. This is ether, substitute. So here the substitute is at second carbon. Here the substitute is at fourth carbon. Benzene ring with single bond C, double bond O, CH3. This is called as, this total compound is called as acetophenone. In the first year, say the benzene also you studied acetophenone. Benzene ring with C, single bond C, double bond O, CH3 is called as acetophenone. And the name of this compound is 2-methoxyacetophenone. Yes. And the second compound is 4-methoxy. IUPAC names are very, very important. You have to remember, you have to understand. The second compound is 4-methoxyacetophenone. Which one is the major product means? Para products are major products. This is the para product. And this is the ortho product. This is going to be the minor product. So this is all about Friedel-Crafts acetylation reactions. Friedel-Crafts acetylation is also called as acylation reaction. And the last reaction in this chapter, the last reaction, nitration. Of course, you know this one also, nitration. Just a minute, I have to take the attendance because the time is less. Wait a minute. And if I'm taking the attendance after this one, some students are leaving the class. Everything is going to be recorded from my side. Who is listening the class? Who is absenting to the class? Wait a minute, ma. If you are having the textbook, please go through the textbook. For 2 minutes, please go through the textbook. Nitration. For nitration reactions, please go through the textbook. If anybody leave the class without ending the session, the attendance is not considered. I'm very particular about attendance. Yes, thank you for your patience. Yes, coming to the point, last one, third one. Nitration of anisole. I think so, no need to explain. You can understand. Nitration of anisole. To carry the nitration of anisole, first we are taking the anisole. And always to carry the nitration reactions, most of the times we are going to take a mixture of concentrated HNO3 mixed with concentrated H2SO4. HNO3 called as nitric acid. H2SO4 is called as sulfuric acid. Both are taken in 1:1 ratio. If it is taken in one part, suppose 1 ml, this is taken in 1 ml. So a mixture of 1:1 ratio of concentrated HNO3 with concentrated H2SO4, that mixer is called as nitration mixer. And in this nitration reactions, what is the electrophile? What is the electrophile going to be formed? This is the CET bit. What is the electrophile going to be formed? NO2 plus ion is the electrophile going to be formed, and the electrophile is going to be substituted at ortho position and para position. Now we can write the products. First, by taking danisole as it is. Again, I am taking danisole to write the two products at a time. First, I am taking danisole. Ortho position is going to be substituted. This is the ortho position going to be substituted with NO2 group, and this is the para position going to be substituted with NO2 group. Yes, tell me, there are nitro group. Nitro group is acting as a substitute only. Nitroethane, nitromethane, nitrobenzene. If we say nitro before any word, that is acting as substitute. So here nitro groups are acting as substitutes. Then we have to say the name. This position is going to be the second position now, and this position is going to be the fourth position now. So the compound is named as 2-nitro. What is the name? 2-nitro anisole. And the second compound is 4-nitro anisole. 4-nitro anisole is the para product, and it is the major product. 2-nitro anisole is the ortho product, and it is the minor product. So this is all about nitration of anisole. And my dear students, electrophilic substitution reactions of anisole, if you are seeing the textbook, yes, I'm going to share the textbook. This is important for 3 marks. The question is important for 3 marks for PO level. It is important for 3 marks. Once you can check this one in your NCERT textbook. Of course, I will send the PDF also. So this is all about alcohols, phenols, and ethers chapter. Please try to complete the MCQs from objective exercise 1 and 2. Just by listening to the classes, you can easily solve this one, right? And text me whether the class is understood or not. Don't leave the session. First of all, give your response in the chat box. All the students must text. If it is not understood, you can mention the same. All the students, please text your response. And on the screen, just text your response. On the screen, you can see the in-text questions. Try to solve these in-text questions. And answers are available in the NCERT exemplar. That will be available in the market. That will be available in the online, Amazon. In the Amazon, it is available, NCERT exemplar. I will text in the group. Please watch the messages in the groups properly. Every day I'm giving so many suggestions, instructions. Please watch the messages in the WhatsApp groups. My number is changed, 94902836667. 94902836667. Please save this number for your communication. Please change my number, 94902836667.